So today we're just going to think a little bit about posture. We were talking about mobility and fluidity last week, so we're going to do some posture exercises. So we're just going to start off with a high knee march. Bring the knee all the way up, extending the opposite hip flexor. Does everybody have a band? Sorry, I forgot to distribute them. Looks like it. And we're going to squat and come. Squat and come. So we're going to be thinking about having a nice tall posture and doing some core exercises to help. Okay, side lunges. Tipping the pelvis. Let's go back around the other way.
What about my knees?
You're cracking up.
Maybe all these pelvic circles is why I have 1,000 views in one of my videos. A bit weird. Alright, gate openers. Not trying to deter anybody, but still. A variation of the exercise we did last week. So hands on the head, and we're just going to twist and check the back of our heel. Coming to centre, twist and check the back of the heel. So you should feel that in your thoracic spine. Get a good twist around. Coming up to centre, twisting and checking. More each side. And now we'll shoe the chickens. So flat back, bottom out, toes up, stretching the hamstrings. Relaxing the ankles as we leap. I've already lost count, so. 9, 10. Alright, so we'll get straight into it. The first exercise we're going to do is skaters. Let me set the timer. Alright, let's go. Thank you. two, one. Change leg. Let's go in 3, 2, 1. This is my knot's very deep range inside. This one, so it's really hard to flex the toe, and especially when it had to do the work of 2 feet on Saturday. And time, yes. Alright, we're going to do twist and raise. So we start off in a squat position with our air ball, and we twist and raise the side. Let's go! Coming up tall every time. Let's think about our posture. Relax the standing foot. Just 10 seconds. And change leg. Let's go, let's get our air ball. Coming up tall at the top. Like me, you start on your good side. You're probably on your wobbly side, but we're going to do it the other way around the next round. So we'll start on our less good side. So we'll give that side a chance to really work. And time. Okay, slightly gentle. We are going to do a glute stretch squat. So, on one leg, let's go. Which makes one warm. Last few seconds, let's see if we can do some really good ones. And change sides. Just get your balance going. Now, the knee drop open. Upwards with our lower abs here, pulling to upright. Three, two, one. Okay, let's go around again. This time we're going to start our skaters with a skater hop. Let's go. So make sure you've got your balance first. Use all of these exercises as a chance to come up tall, have nice posture. 10 seconds. Seconds. And time. Okay. This side should be a little bit easier. Going in three. Let's get think of pulling up through the core. Come all the way to vertical, so your shoulders are above your hips. Let's practice good form. That's what we want when we're running. Shoulders, hips, ankles in line. Let's imprint that in all our exercises. And, all right, starting on our wrong leg, so that's your left leg standing, we're going to do our glute stretch squat. Let's go. This one's not a good start. But focus on pulling up from the lower arms. Sit into it and pull up. Sit. Relax the foot. And time. Let's get into position. Make sure your standing foot is facing forward. Left foot on your knee. Squat and pull. Pushing down, pulling up, pushing down, pulling up. Coming all the way back to standing, remember, nice and tall at the top. That's it. Halfway, let's really focus on pulling in and coming up tall. A few more seconds. Come on. Squat. Pull up tall. And time. Alright, we'll be pleased to let's end that round. We'll start the next round with a single leg deadlift. So, right leg is going to be the standing leg, left leg up, left arm up. Off we go. If you can touch the floor, so much the better. And okay, so have a little bit of a release from all of that. We're going to do some ankle flexibility, so we're going to raise one leg and we're going to pulse the other foot up and down. No hurry, we're trying to get to the end of range, so point and flex. Circles. Let's go around one way. And back the other way. And release. Change legs. Standing tall. Let's pick up our right leg. Put it to your chest. And flex and point. focusing on getting a little bit more range with each breath. And circle clockwise, relax the standing foot, and anti-clockwise. We're going to do stability lunges, so it's a lunge, and then we come up, keeping our hips square, and raise that back leg. Let's go. We'll just do one side, hold it. See if you can get to horizontal. Last one. And time. Change legs. Let's go. Deep lunge, coming up, lifting that leg. Use your core to keep you in place. And time. Well done. Okay. We're going to do a single leg off and hold. Like so. Doesn't need to be a massive leap. You need to stabilize. Try to stay tall as you're doing it. Just a few more seconds. Three, two, one. And change it. Let's go. In 3, 2, 1. Think about using your core to keep you upright. Single leg deadlift. We're going to start with our left leg standing, right arm up, right knee up. Let's get into it. Coming up tall. Soft knee. So let's lift our left arm and our left knee, soften that right knee. Just using your strong core. assist your leg and getting you to standing and coming all the way up. Standing on our left leg, we're going to lift our right leg and flex and point. All the way up and all the way down. And now circle clockwise. Challenges are real today, and the other way. And change legs. Balance on the right leg, lift the left leg, and let's pulse it up and down. Come a bit taller. Shoulders back. And let's go for clockwise circles. And anti-clockwise. Our stability lunges, so left leg is our standing leg, right leg is our lunging leg, let's go, reverse lunge, and coming up. Think about getting to horizontal, like a plane, a bird. And time. Let's change legs. Lunging back on the left leg. Time. We're going to hop the hold. We're going to start with our left leg. Going in 3, 2, 1. Think about using your core to stabilize. What do I mean by that? I mean drawing up through the pelvis. Focus on your core and make it work. And time. So, right leg hopping, drawing up through the pelvis, let's go. Think about where you want your weight to be when you land. We go, bands around feet, side steps. Keeping the band under tension, so not bringing your feet in too close together. Nice and tall, and guess what? It's another opportunity to think about pulling in through the core, pull up from the pelvis, shoulders are relaxed, you're nice and tall, you're nice and aligned, think of yourself as being a tall column with sore glutes. Oh, this time, we'll just get through. We missed the best. We were fucking around anyway, so it's all good. I think how strong we'll be. We don't need to focus too much on our balance or what we're doing with our knee, apart from pulling it up high, so we can focus on drawing and pulling, can't we, and keeping us tall, looking straight ahead. I distract you.
It's the one you keep in mind.
Yes. Seconds. All the way up. Give it a squeeze. Okay. Let's have our band around our knee. We're going to do lunges. Is everyone okay with lunges? If you want to do something different, if you haven't got lunges in you, you can just come out to the side. If you have got lunges in you, let's go for alternating lunges. Big step, feet hip width apart. I did try this around the ankles, but it just pings up, so you get more resistance, but it's a bit annoying. Okay. We are going to do triangle touch with the band around the ankles. So extending to the front, to the side, and the back. Center, find your balance. Standing tall. Let's go. 3, 2, 1. Standing leg is soft, not locked out with the knee. The chest does need to be up. Upright, so your shoulders are in line with your hips and in line with your ankles. Relaxed but strong. That's what we want to aspire to in our running. Be relaxed and strong and focused. Right, looking at the clock this time, you can see it's time for some little rest. And we go again. 3, 2, 1. Up we go. Using your core to pull your pelvis into neutral alignment. So starting off with our right knee raised and left foot standing. Seconds. Stay tall. And time. Change sides. Come up tall. Pull in. Find your weight on the standing leg to balance even. Standing leg will give you a bit more range. A bit of a new system there. Okay, let's have the band around the knees. and go again. Keep your knees in line, not your lifted knee just coming out to the side, it's not coming forward. A little bit more into the glute. That way. Alright. Keeping the band around the knee. This time we're going to do semicircles, except we can do like a 270, so much better. Let's go. On our hands and knees. I'll just pause this. We're going to thread the needle. Does everybody know how to thread the needle? So, alright, so you want to start off on all fours, like so. You want to keep your back end of the horse stays still, and the front end, you're threading the needle through here. Your head is looking in the direction of your hand, and we're just going to alternate. So we're going to start the timer, but we've got two rounds of it, so there's plenty of time to get into it. So we're alternating, like so.
You have to bend your elbow.
You can bend your elbow, yeah. So we're releasing the thoracic spine. Trying to keep the back end stable. Having this mobility in our thoracic spine is going to help us when we run. Let's just pause it now, we'll go again in a minute. 3, 2, 1. So we have the movement and the range when one leg comes forward, one shoulder goes back. Down a little bit lower. And time. Okay, now we're going to do a Michael Mosey pleasing blood pressure lowering plank. I knew it was coming. So try to keep everything in line. Don't pike up. Don't dip down. I'll count you through. See if you can get your hips a little bit lower, so they should be in line with your ankles and your shoulders. Hips down, hips down, hips down. That's halfway. Head up. Keep those thighs from sinking down. We've just got a few more seconds. Looking good, everybody. 3, 2, 1. You've just dropped your knees for a moment. And the next exercise, we're going to do a plank and a leg raise. So we stay as the best we can in plank position. And just alternating a leg raise. You might find your plank, your plank up a little bit. But come try, try to come down to plank each time. Very nice. A nice straight line there, Heather. And knees. And time. Okay. All right. Coming into sitting position. I think I'm going to need to pause there, so I'm sorry. Coming into sitting position when you're ready. We're going to do some Russian twists and V-sits. Our favourite. Let's go. Feet off the mat. Take it slow. Twisting all the way around.
Doesn't help when it's a gem.
Slow it down. Control it. Your shoulders following your hands. They are a fixed unit. Two, one, and V-sit. So we remember what we're doing here. Hands on the mat, fingers facing forward, tuck in, and push away onto your forearms. Let's go. Work the core, keep it light everywhere else. Halfway, all the way up, all the way back. Just 10 seconds, come on. Relax the shoulders. And time. All right, so we're going to do hamstring walkouts. So onto the mat, on your back. Pause that. So coming up into a glute bridge, you want to make sure that your pelvis is tucked under and you're just stepping out. Few steps and stepping back in again. As soon as you feel your pelvis start to tip, it's a sign you've gone too far. So you want to keep it locked up there. Let's go in 3, 2, 1. Loose hamstrings, you can hold it a little bit higher up so you can get a slightly bigger angle. Relax that leg. If they're tight, you might want to hold it lower down. And change legs. down time. Okay, you know what we're doing now, we're going to stop the clock, so we'll go back to threading the needle. So on all fours, hands under your shoulders, let's go. Let's come all the way through. It'll look really good, twist. If you can keep your bottom still, you isolate the thoracic spine. Can you feel that?
Yes.
Oh, you must be very happy. And time. All right, let's go again. Keeping the tail as still as possible. To do something else. We'll do something else instead of the Russian twists. Do it please, no.
What?
Don't worry, I'm just whispering. Okay, we're going to go back into plank position. We're going to do a plank variation and do shoulder taps. So, you're in high plank position. Let's go. Alternating shoulder taps. Try to keep your hips as level as possible. You can just widen your feet if you need to stabilise. Nice and steady. Let's not rush through these. Keep the hips as level as possible, try not to rock around. And time. And now we're going to do knee to elbow. You can go same side knee to same side elbow, or we can go across the body. So we're going to stay in that high plank position. Let's go. Just 10 seconds. And time. Okay, so instead of doing the Russian twists, I know there was a bit of moaning, we are going to go onto our tummies and paddle. So arms and legs off the mat and paddling away joyously. Are we ready? Let's go. Extending away. Jen, you're going to get to France at that rate. Really going for it.
It's not my legs.
Extend, extend. Arms away. 15 seconds. 10, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Next up, we're going to do hitchhikers. So, thumbs out, round,
plunge down.
Okay? Oh, just need to, reset that since we've done millions of reps. Okay, you've got a reprieve. No longer. Let's go. So it's like we're doing breaststroke. Relaxing our bottom half though. Relax your legs down. And just working the back and shoulders. 10 seconds. And time. Okay, so on our backs. It's going to feel nice. We're going to start with our feet close to our bottoms, and we're going to walk away, but we want to keep our pelvis in that position and work your lower abs. Okay? I'm going to set the timer. It's just an opportunity to really focus and isolate that movement. Let's go. So your back is pressed, your lower spine is pressed into the mat, and you're using your lower abs to keep your pelvis in that position. Walk all the way out, your feet straight, but keeping the back pressed into the mat and not letting it arch up. Focus on keeping the back and the spine pressed into the mat, not letting there be a gap. Alright, let's do this again. Let's go. 3, 2, 1. Just focusing in on that area. Learning how to engage those lower legs. That part of the core is strong. It means it can keep your pelvis in alignment. Which is what we need for effort-free running. Be in the right position. And time. Okay. Let's stop the clock. And
come on. 61 minutes.
Pardon?
61 minutes.
It's not over yet. On your hands and knees, please. Just a few minutes more. This is the fun
bit. This is
the nice bit, yes. Let's just run through a few rounds of cat-cow. All the way up, tummy buttons and spine, dropping all the way through. All the way. And all. Coming back to neutral, tucking your toes under. Let's come into downward dog. Nice high dog, hips high, legs strong, thighs pressing to the back of the row. Drop your head through. And pedal. Keeping the ankles as open as you can at the front. And close in. And come back to your dog. So if you can press the ankles down even more, think about opening them up as much as possible. And that will bring you up in the shoulder and the hip as well. And pedal, heels to the mat. High dog, press the quads to the back of the legs, heels to the floor, ankles open, and come back, drop back down to your knees, come into kneeling, let's relax our feet and ankles and just sit on our heels for a moment if we can. Relax the feet. And using your shins, push up to standing. And we're all done. Oh.